The table represents a linear or exponential function. We're asked to find the equation of the function. So the first step is to analyze the table to see if we have a linear function or an exponential function. When we have a linear function, the function values have a pattern of repeated addition, and when we have an exponential function, the function values have a pattern of repeated multiplication. So looking at the table, notice how the inputs or x values increase by 1, and the function values go from negative 5 to negative 7, negative 7 to negative 9, and negative 9 to negative 11. So we probably recognize that negative 5 minus 2 equals negative 7, negative 7 minus 2 equals negative 9, and negative 9 minus 2 equals negative 11. But the notes say there must be a pattern of repeated addition to have a linear function. But we know that minus 2 is the same as adding negative 2, so we could also express this pattern as plus negative 2. And therefore, we now know we have a linear function. So now we'll find the equation of linear function in the form f of x equals mx plus b, where m is the slope, which equals the change in the output divided by the change in the input, and b is the vertical intercept, also known as the initial or starting amount. So looking at our table of values, because we know we have a linear function, notice how this column gives us the ordered pair 0, comma, negative 5. And because we're given this ordered pair, this tells us that b, the vertical intercept, is equal to negative 5. So now we just need to find the slope. To find the slope, we'll use two ordered pairs in the table and determine the change in the output divided by the change in the input. It does not matter which two ordered pairs we use. Let's go ahead and use these two ordered pairs here, where the first ordered pair is 0, comma, negative 5. The second ordered pair is 1, comma, negative 7. So in general, the slope, m, is equal to the change in the output, or the change in the function value, divided by the change in the input, or in this case, the change of x. So to determine the change in the output, we need to find the difference of negative 7 and negative 5. To determine the change in the input, we need to find the difference of 1 and 0. Sometimes you'll also see this formula as quantity y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by the quantity x sub 2 minus x sub 1. But again, in general, the slope is equal to the change in the output divided by the change in the input. So showing our work here, we'd have negative 7 minus negative 5 divided by 1 minus 0. This would be negative 7 plus 5 divided by 1, which equals negative 2 divided by 1, which equals negative 2. So now we know the slope m is equal to negative 2. One thing to be careful about is that the slope m is not always going to be the value that we're adding to find the next function value in the table. It will only be the same as the slope if the inputs or x values are increasing by 1 in the table. So I think it's important to always go through this formula here to determine the change in the output divided by the change in the input using two ordered pairs. Now that we have all the information we need, we now know the linear function is f of x equals, well, m is equal to negative 2, so we have negative 2x, and then b is equal to negative 5. Instead of writing plus negative 5, it's more common to just write minus 5. Of course, we can verify our work graphically by graphing this function on the coordinate plane and make sure it contains these points. So let's look at the graph before we go. This line is the graph of f of x equals negative 2x minus 5, and notice how it does contain the 4 points from the table, verifying our work is correct. Notice how if we were to go from this point to this point on the right, we would have to go down 2 units and right 1 unit, verifying the slope is negative 2 or negative 2 over 1. The change in the output is a decrease of 2 every time the input increases by 1. I hope you found this helpful.